Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In part 1 on expression animation in Flame, we looked at animation channel relationships, as well as linking them through an expression. We also started covering basic expression syntax, which included basic mathematics, such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. In part 2, you'll start expanding expressions across multiple objects through an understanding of channel hierarchy in the animation editor. You'll also learn to determine a value at a specific point in time. And finally, you'll learn an expression function, which allows you to offset the start time of an expression across multiple objects. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the description below. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast, then please type the displayed link in your web browser. Go ahead and load the batch setup and go into the first action node example. If you scrub or play the composite, you can see that there is a keyframed animation on the 2 geometry. Now we would like the expression's text geometry to move vertically in the composite. However, we would like the timing to match the horizontal movement of the 2 geometry. If you're using a 2-up view and looking at the action schematic, you'll see the nodes that are used for this composite. There are 2 geometry nodes for the 3D text, and 2 axis nodes that control the animation for each geometry. Now for clarity's sake, you are going to rename each axis node so you'll be able to see the relationships that will be established by the expression. The axis of the 2 geometry will be renamed as the parent. The axis of the expression's geometry will be renamed as the child. Keep an eye on case sensitivity when you type, as uppercase and lowercase letters are viewed as unique by the expression. Now the parent axis has horizontal movement for the 2 geometry. If you look in the object menu and focus on the X position, you can see that as the time bar is scrubbed or played, the value updates. Let's create the expression in the animation editor. Holding down the Shift key, click once on the X position slider to select it. Switch to the animation editor, and the X position channel and its curve is currently selected. Now the means in which you identify a channel when writing an expression is to look at the hierarchy of the channels in the animation editor. For example, at the top of the structure, the axis name is parent. Parent expands out to position. And finally, position expands out to the X, Y, and Z channels. Each expandable triangle represents a level. So when writing an expression, you use a full stop to separate out the channel hierarchy. So the correct way to read the absolute path of the horizontal channel is parent.position.x. By knowing the absolute path of a channel means that it is very possible to link one channel to another across different objects in the composite. Now to start off the expression, ensure the X position channel is still selected and press the copy button. Back in the action schematic, select the child axis, and all its channels will highlight in the animation editor. Scroll the list, and you will see the child's entry. If needed, you can expand the triangles until it shows all the position channels for the node. Select the Y position channel in the list. Click the link button and the expression is created. Looking at the bottom of the graph, Flame has given you the absolute path of the parent axis's position. Scrubbing or playing the composite, you will see how the horizontal position of one object is driving the vertical position of another object. Remember, at any time, this expression can be edited, and you can continue to develop this value if you choose. Now let's move on to the second example. Go back to Batch and choose the second action node. Press Alt 2 for the 2-up view. In this example, you are going to learn a method called the control axis technique. This is where you take an axis with nothing attached and use it as a null or dummy object to apply animation to a bunch of linked channels. In the action schematic, you already have an axis called control. To make this clear, I will go to the object menu for the control axis and move the axis icon above the geometry in the composite. This step is not really necessary, but it will make this axis easier to see. Currently, if you scrub the time bar, you can see that there is no animation in the scene. Go to frame 1 and turn on Auto Key to start creating animation. Hold Ctrl and click on the Z rotation channel. This keyframes the control axis channel at the current frame with the default value of 0. Now using the time bar, scrub to frame 10. Once again, in the Z rotation, set the value to 360 degrees. Turn Auto Key off. Now when you scrub between frame 1 and frame 10, the control axis icon is rotating in the scene. If you want the manipulator to rotate with the object, change the behavior from world to object and scrub the composite again. Now we would like the rotation to affect all the geometry in the scene. However, I would like you to consider using different rotation channels to make this animation more dynamic. So switch to the animation editor. Collapse the first example so you don't see any of its animation curves. In the second example, scroll to the control axis channels and expose the rotation channels. Select the Z rotation, and if you don't see the whole curve, click frame to fit it in the window. Once again, click copy to store the curve to memory. Next, you need to access all the rotation channels in the various nodes. To give you a bigger view of the animation editor, swipe to the right of the screen. Let's collapse all the channels and slowly expand what you need. So at the very top of the editor, hold Alt and close the triangle. Next, hold Shift Alt and expand the channels for the second example. Now the nodes are labeled from axis 1 to axis 5 in the schematic, and this is visible in the animation channels. Start off by expanding axis 1, rotation, and select the X rotation channel. You'll also need to select the other channels at the same time, so remember to hold Ctrl when creating a multi-channel selection. Expand axis 2, rotation, and control select the Y rotation channel. This is followed by axis 3, rotation, and control select the Y rotation channel. Next, axis 4, rotation, and control select the X rotation channel. And finally, axis 5, rotation, and control select the Y rotation channel. Pressing the link button will create the expression on all 5 selected channels. So you now have 5 channels from multiple objects, all driven by one animation channel on the control axis node. Swipe right again to swap the viewports. If you scrub the composite, you can see the control axis animation is affecting all the geometries but on different rotation channels. In terms of flexibility, you can change the values in the rotation of the control axis and each node will react accordingly. But one big point I'd like to highlight is that all the animation happens at the same time. So what if you wanted the animation in each channel to be delayed by a certain amount of time? For instance, one animation starts, followed by the next, and so on. In order to do this, you need to use 2 expression functions: evaluate and selection order. We'll come to evaluation in just a moment, but selection order always comes first because this works in the order in which you selected your channels. So in the animation editor, you'll reselect the channels to get the correct selection order. scroll the list, and select the rotation of axis 1. Now hold Ctrl and select the other rotation channels in the order of the ascending axis numbering all the way through axis 5. Now click the Expressions button or press close square bracket. Place the cursor at the beginning of the line, and the first thing you need to type is eval open bracket. This means you are about to perform an evaluation function. The purpose of evaluation is to work out a value and take time into account when the value is generated. So evaluation always consists of two parts. The first part is what you're evaluating. This is the value from control.rotation.z. The second part is time. To separate the parts of an evaluation function, you place a comma after the first part with no spaces. Press space and type frame. With the current evaluation expression, each geometry will have the same value because they are all evaluating the rotation at the same point in time. That's frame 1. So we need to tell each channel to start the animation incrementally at a different frame in the composite. In other words, we would like axis 1 to start rotating at frame 1, axis 2 to start rotating at frame 2, and so on. This is where we use selection order. In the expression editor, we carry on typing. Type minus selection order. Close the brackets to complete the evaluation expression. Please ensure that you capitalize the S and the O, as expressions are case sensitive. When you press Enter, you will see all the expression curves spread out by one frame. And looking at the visible expression, selection order has been replaced with a number indicating this channel's specific selection order. Scrubbing the composite, each of the geometries start rotating one frame after each other. Perhaps you would like a 5-frame delay between rotations. With all the channels still selected in the current order, open the expressions editor with closed square bracket. The editor shows you the expression for one of the selected channels. A great tip is if you press the up and down arrows on the keyboard, it will shuffle through your last typed commands. Here you will find the original expression that was typed. To delay the expression by 5 frames in each channel, we need to multiply the frame offset by 5. After the selection order function, type times 5. Pressing Enter again will apply the expression to the channels. Looking at the animation curves again, you will see how each curve is offset by 5 frames. If you scrub or play the composite, you will see the intended result. As I said earlier, if you change the animation in the Control Axis node, it will affect all the nodes with the expression, but this time, each node will be delayed by 5 frames. Have a go at experimenting with different animations and time delays using evaluation and selection order. In the next video, we'll go over some of this again, but you'll also learn about some other functions known as random generators. Please subscribe for updates to the Flame Learning channel, and comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thanks for watching.